So I just let the horses out. They got finished out here. And they're both like, what the hell is that? So buddy's like, dude, that used to be my mats. What's that checkered shit? Now see, that could look like a little bit of a, like a cattle grain, because it messes with their shade. I'm gonna scare them because I don't want them going in here. Watch this. I don't want you guys going in there. Boy, Ransom has just like been limping lately. I checked his front foot. It's not warm. I don't see any abscess, but he's really limping. So in case they do go in here, I gotta have this shut a little bit because I don't want them roaming all night. Hang on, I'm gonna scare buddy. Go see your little girl. All right. So now they got another one to deal with over there. They're like, holy shit, what's over here? Oh man, I'll be glad when this is over. I hate kind of disrupting everything. You know, you get everything the way it's done. I'm probably gonna hose this down a little bit and pack it down. So it'll be nice and wet and dry in the concrete from the bottom. So Ransom's like, oh shit. They got yellow tape shit over here too. So I gotta get that other water bucket and I'll put their water bucket by the fence. Let me hide back here and do some cognito filming on them. Can you guys see them? Those aren't rattlesnakes. Everybody's like, dude, you got rattlesnakes. Those are locusts, sequoia, whatever you want to call them. We call them Texas locusts. Also, here's a gate I forgot to close. So buddy gonna go check on his little girl. And I'm gonna bring another water bucket out here. Even though I got one on the other side, I'm gonna put one over here for them because they're used to coming here. So Ransom wants to hide his little girl. She's like, dude, you abandoned me. All right, so that concrete's done. And this one's done. All you concrete experts out there can tell me how I did it wrong or what I should have done. I like the way they move this. That's me not thinking. He said, we can pick this up and move it and we'll straighten it up for you. And I'm like, dude, you know how deep these are? You know how hard it was for me to pull these up out of the ground? And they didn't even go all the way down. These things are deep. And instead of digging it all the way up, they just dug a hole in front and then forced it forward and pried it forward to level it up, which probably somebody's gonna say they tweaked this a little bit. It probably tweaked this a little bit because this is pretty hard, but it's still, it's a good tie post for horses. And now that one's gonna be in concrete. So that'll be really good because that'll be good in concrete. So all that's gonna fill up with concrete. And this will be the pad. I still don't know how he's gonna do that lip, but I guess we'll see. Supposedly they know what they're doing, because I don't. That's why I called them. That's why you people like, why don't you frame yourself? They were out here at 8 o'clock in the morning. It is now 5 in the afternoon and they just left. They said they're gonna be out here at 9:30 in the morning and concrete should be here by 12 or 1. And he said he's gonna flatten down that that area out there. He left the backhoe out here. He probably doesn't care if I would like to go grab a couple trees. I wonder if I should call the dude and say, hey, do you mind if I move a couple trees? I don't know if he's getting charged by the hour, though. I don't want to raise his hourly bill on that by using it. But I got a couple trees on the tree line that I could really use that to push out. Maybe when they get out here at 9:30 in the morning, if they ain't doing shit, I'll see if he'll just go stack me a burn pile. Give him $100 or something. So I didn't have to pull too much out of here. I'm gonna give you a tip. When you have people working around your place, if you leave tools out, they're gonna use it. These shovels were like on the ground and they were using them, which I don't really care. I mean, but last time they used my wheelbarrow, they left a hole in it. They cracked it. And then they weren't going to tell me. And I had to call the guy out here and go, hey, you need to give me a new wheelbarrow. Your guy's cracked it. So I don't mind if they use it. So this is where I ran my electrical wire from the shed over there, because this place didn't have any electricity when I got here. So I just ran this wire underground straight off that electric, ran it in here, and ran the switch, and then ran it up to where now I have a light and I got a plug over there, because this didn't have any electricity. So I guess the concrete's just gonna go around this thing. Somebody's probably gonna say I should move it and whatever. I mean, this place is gonna be better than it was. So that was kind of my philosophy in the military and jobs. When you go to a new job or a new place, or even go to the bathroom and leave it, wipe down the counter, leave it better than you found it. If everybody did that, we'd have a lot of nicer place to live in, but. So I was trying to count how many damn mats I got. There's too damn many to count. These things are $40. How much money I got in damn mats? Looks like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Maybe 17 or 18. We'll go 20. 20 mats here. Then another 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. So we'll go 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36 on the other side. And then whatever they are, I'll stack here. 36 plus those 10. So almost 50 freaking mats. And you can never have enough because they're just handy. Oh, I forgot the two over underneath the horse trailer. Damn, this video is going to be long, but if you want to hang around, I got some of that, my wood lathe was like rusting everywhere. I kind of scraped it and sprayed it down with that spray stuff. And then I put the paint on rust stuff on here because it was really rusty. I mean, it had big bumps, and I brushed it down, put that paint on rust, left it on for a day, and then I got my spray can and I just sprayed over it. And I may go ahead and spray some black paint over it, I'm not sure. But I just need to stop that damn rust. But this piece right there is heavy as shit, and it fits right on top of here for the motor fan belt to come up. So it had a whole bunch of rust on it, so I had to scrape it off and kind of paint it up. I think it's almost dry. Probably is dry. And so then that's going to go back on top of here, and then the other pieces. My garage is trashed right now. Wow. And these are the other pieces on top of that wood lathe, like the guide and stuff that I went ahead and painted down. These are the concrete posts that we're going to put in the pad so they can weld a bar for the roof on it. So those have to go into the concrete. They got four little things, and the concrete go all along here, and then that'll be level with the concrete. And then I pulled off this horsey and cleaned him up, brushed him down and hosed him, and I'm going to paint him with that rust stuff, so it'll turn black like this. And then I'm gonna paint on the side of this guy's neck Mr. T's little brand right here, because Mr. T was a Mustang and he had brand right here. So I'm gonna get a little, I've got these little brushes I got at a garage sale, I think, for like $1 or some shit. How the hell is this thing open? So all these little brushes were in here, and I was like, I could probably use them to touch up things in the house. So it's $1 for all these brushes, and I went, shit. And I've used a bunch, because usually I throw them away when I'm done. So I'm going to get one of these and paint the little freeze brand on Mr. T's neck. And so those are the damn projects. I don't think I got anything else going on. I had to pull the, I gave Stewie away. The guy took Stewie. He said his little daughter loves it and is already playing with it and holding it and everything. So I don't need those stacked up on the outside of the house anymore. So I blew them out with the air gun to get all the dead hay out of it because it gets moldy as it sits in there. And I got those stacked there. I don't know what I'm going to do with these pallets. I used to bring a whole bunch of wood in here and use plastic pallets, but I think the plastic pallets, because they hold grass, makes it mold more. Moki's finally coming out because of people. Did everybody leave, Moki? You've been in here all day. He's like, dude, there's all been strangers out there. So wood, I guess, gives a little bit more breather way. Over here, I just put them over to 4x4s and lifted it off the ground. That way, if a mouse gets under there, Moki can go under. See, Moki can't get a mouse in here, but under here, he can get a mouse because I made it high enough. So when he's in there hunting the little critters, I put you some snacks over here, boy. I put you some snacks over here, your little favorite treats. All right. So this is drying up nice. Not real nice. I'm getting black shit on me, so it's not that dry. I figure that one's pretty dry, though. Damn, that thing's freaking heavy as hell, too. It's not as much as those damn... But there was rust on the inside and all kind of crap. And so I scraped it down with that wire brush and then just gave it a good spray with that Rust-Oleum rust converter. So hopefully that'll stick to it. I mean, I could paint it up and make it look nice with a nice glossy paint, but I just want to stop the rust. So I was glad I didn't have to move these, because I thought we were gonna have to move these out of the way, and I was like, shit, I don't want to move those damn things again. So they're gonna pour in the morning or the afternoon tomorrow. So that's the project. We'll see how it goes. Okay, so after the guy who these guys are working for came out, he said, yeah, they should have put a ridge around. You can tell they dug out a little bit deeper. He said the reason for that ridge is so water doesn't seep under your concrete and wash out your pad. So you should have a ridge around the edge of your concrete pads. I've seen a lot of pads. I never knew that was the case. Now on this one, they only dig because the back part is the metal. They didn't put a ridge on the back part for some reason. I'm not sure why, but they did on the front and along here. And they're supposed to come out and pour in a couple hours. So I have this here. Okay. Just showed up finally late as hell. So see how this goes. There's a buddy wanting to help.
Hi buddy!
So, dude, what are they doing to my house? So I guess they're gonna start here first. Like it's coming. It's like, dude, just let me out. I'll show you guys how to do it. That looks pretty thick to me, which is good from what I hear. Maybe it's getting softer. So I think they're just going to do that side, and then they're going to come on this side and do the other side. So, that's why it's just coming over here. That's a lot of concrete. Whew. The truck supposedly has 10 yards in it.
Hell, I thought for sure they were gonna hit that freaking thing. They got the thing so close. Don't tear down my barn with that big ass dump truck.
One truck, 10 yards, what enough? He ordered 10, he thought it would do all four pads. It only did two. Start the other one, so. Crap, I gotta get another truck. Okay, so they ran out of concrete here. Got some more coming. Boys are ready to get out of there. Oh shit, that's a new truck, damn. And here's the, I think the finished product over here. So that little piece of wood's gonna come out and that's gonna be a ledge for my mat so they don't spread out. So still letting that one dry out and settle, I guess. And it's just putting a brushing finish on this one. Evidently this brush is going to help the mats from sliding around.